Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm gonna show you guys how to draw heads for your characters. Obviously in paper because it's kind of hard drawing digitally on IBS Paint or Procreate or whatever, or Clip Studio Paint or whatever digital art app you use, or software, or whatever you'd like to call it. So yeah, the things you're gonna need for this are paper, a pencil and pen. Instead of pen, maybe you could use a marker, but it really depends what you like to use. You might need an eraser if you make any mistakes along the way. And you're gonna need a color pencils or colored markers or stuff. I'm gonna use some alcohol markers for basically coloring, and this colored pencil for the skin color. So let's go.
So you're gonna start by drawing a circle at the top of the page. You can make it overlap if you want, like this, but it's really better if you overlap it, which will give you like more stability, I guess. I don't really know what the word for it is, but it'll help more, I guess. Then you're gonna draw a line through the circle, which is going to be curved or straight. It depends on the direction your character is gonna be facing. We're gonna make this character over here face forward. Next, you're gonna connect the circle to the bottom of the line, and the bottom of the line is basically gonna be where the chin sits. So, yeah. Now, just a little bit before the circle ends, you're gonna draw a curved line like this, and like beneath it, you're gonna draw another line. Over here is where the bottom of the nose will sit, and over here, we're gonna draw the eyes, and maybe even the eyebrows. So, it really depends on your art style, on the way the eyes will look, but my art style is kind of like this, so I like to draw like the top of the eyes shape like this. I don't really know how to explain it, but it's kind of like a sort of curved line like that, and then like a little cat eye look on the top. So yeah, and then you're gonna draw like this, and very lightly you can very lightly just do that. So yeah, you can see that the eyes are done for the sketch anyway. Then you can draw the mouth, which is supposed to sit like somewhere over there, and the eyebrows can be right above the eyes. The eyebrows really do kind of affect the expression, so I recommend putting in extra focus when you're doing that. Then you can just find a spot, and then you can like decide how long you want the hair to be. But before that, let's draw the neck. I know I said I would only like do the head, but like the neck really does, it affects this a lot. So now that we've gotten this all set, let's do the hair. So then you can just figure out where you want the hair to end and stuff, and yeah. If you're drawing a girl, then you should keep in mind that the chin is going to be like more pointy like this, or like thinner, I guess. I don't really know how to explain it. But if you're drawing like a boy, then you should have the chin more broad. And you should have like the hair going from a specific point instead of like the middle of the head. I'm gonna complete this sketch with the body and stuff. There will be a a link in the description to... Never mind. I'll just show you how to complete this first, and then we can move on with the body and stuff. So, the first thing we're gonna do now is that we're gonna use pen and go over it. I really recommend using pen because, yeah, the first thing that we did was like a sketch, so I really hope you didn't do that with the pen if you're doing this along with me. I am terrible at line art, so please just try your best and don't copy me for the line art because I'm terrible at it. So basically just trace on top of your sketch. It's not really considered copying if you're the one who did it. This is how most artists, hopefully all artists, because the sketch is really important. It really helps give the structure and give you help to see where each bit is gonna go and stuff. So yeah. I personally just like to have the eyes overlap into the hair. Like you can see the outlines, but the color is still going to be of the hair. And I absolutely love doing that in my art style, but it really depends on you and what you want to do. Don't forget the eye to do the eyebrows because they're really important. And then trace on the neck. And you might think, hey, this looks kind of weird. Is this gonna be the only hair? Because it has no depth. Well, if you want, you can just draw a little bit of a body on it as well, which you kind of do have to do. If you want a good tutorial for the body or something like that, a body or a base, then an amazing YouTuber called SparkleMere has made a tutorial on that specifically, so you can go and check out their channel. The link to their channel is in the description, and that video is also in a link form in the description. So yeah. We're just gonna have it like this. So yeah. And then you can have your one little eraser. This eraser is very badly bruised. I hope your eraser looks better. I hope. But anyways, so yeah. Oh, and then silly little me realizes that I forgot to trace the eyes. Wow. Anyways, okay. You shouldn't really trace the bottom of the eyes with your pen because it just isn't the best. Just don't mind me just fixing up a few bits of line art. The sketch is really important. So you can see this here. Now you're gonna take your colors. So here are all the colors we're gonna use for this character, I guess. Let's give her a name. I'm gonna let you guys give her a name in the comments below if you want. Just give her a name, because I have no idea what to name her. So yeah, we're gonna give her green hair. Green hair. Actually, not green hair. Let's just give her like a ginger hair, like Ginny Weasley. But this is not Ginny Weasley. You can make up. This can be like a new character in the Weasley family, like J.K. Rowling. Consider this, please. Anyways, so now you're just gonna do the coloring. The coloring really plays a big role in this. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do the skin first, and I'd like to do the skin first because it really it's basically the first thing that comes to mind. So yeah, but you can do it in basically any order. Just be careful of where you color, and you don't really want to make any mistakes, but it's okay because practice makes perfect. If you make any mistakes, that's alright, you can just try again, and maybe you'll do better next time. And the main goal of this is just to have fun. So, yeah. Unless you're doing this for an art competition, then it's really serious. Anyways, so now we're gonna take a color for the hair. I'm gonna use orange for the hair. Just orange for the top of her head. You can see how I've done it, I just kind of overlapped it, and that's just in my art style, but art can be different with different art styles. So yeah. Oh shoot, the pen. That's all right. That's alright, that's alright, that's alright, that's alright. Okay, now we're gonna go with this darker orange color, which for some reason they called golden. I'm not kidding. It's literally got called golden. I don't know if you can see that or not. I think it's looking quite reversed, but yeah. Now we can do the hair color after we put these to the side for now. We can do her eye color, sorry. We've already done her hair. Eye color, eye color, eye color, eye color. We can use this blue. This is looking a lot like Ginny Weasley. Why am I using the same color scheme as Ginny? I have no idea. But anyways, it's nice to add a little bit of shading, but I like to keep my art very simple. So yeah. And for her shirt, you know what? Why not just go ahead with the random olive green? Why not? So yeah. The shirt is just a little bit of fun, what we did. So yeah, that's how to draw a head. I'll try to leave the links to all the products that I used in the description. I'll try. If I can find the links online, because I bought this in store. So yeah. That was it. I'll see you all in my next video, guys. Consider this video as a Christmas present from me, okay? Because somebody here, me, is not very good at uploading daily or that much. So yeah, if you want to draw the rest of your character, a body or something like that, obviously you do, then I recommend that you check out Sparkle Knit. Her links will be in the description. Yeah. Hope you like this video. Smash that like button if you did. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.